Winnipeg, Florida, 55-56, and I can tell you this is a big time opinion from all of us here on the Ice Guys show. We've got Winnipeg about -120 road favorite, total of 6. Winnipeg Jets playing good hockey. They've against Detroit didn't have a good performance. They were just walking into a buzzsaw. I mean, the Detroit Red Wings, and we said that on Tuesday's show, guys, or I remember saying this for sure. If the Detroit Red Wings are going to show you something after two just debilitating, pathetic, brutal losses against Montreal, blowout, embarrassing, humiliating, that was going to be the spot against the Winnipeg Jets on Tuesday night to show up, you know, with pride, put a balls-to-the-wall 60-minute effort on the ice, and they did that. 5-1 win against Winnipeg the other night. Good performance from Detroit in a desperation, show some pride for yourself type of spot. Detroit did that, maybe caught Winnipeg a little flat. They had a nice little run going, now on the road against an out-of-conference team, a little bit flat. I think Winnipeg will probably bring a better effort, and you like to back good teams off a loss. If you're a good hockey team, if you want to be one of the elite teams in the league, usually when you have a loss and a bad performance, it doesn't sit well with you, and you come back the next game and really fire back strong. I think Winnipeg's going to do that tonight. Winnipeg 6-0 in their last 6 games off a loss. That's the role they're in tonight. No Roberto Luongo, of course, now for Florida. That's a concern. You've got to rely on stiffs like James Reimer in net. That's a problem going forward for this Florida team. He's not been good. And I hate saying that, because in Toronto, when he was a starting goaltender, he gave them some good work there for a period of time. Really played well at times there. Hasn't translated here to a backup role in Florida, especially this year. It's been a rough go. His numbers aren't great. I think Winnipeg's offense could prove to be a bad combination with James Reimer in net for this Florida Panthers team. I'm going to look side and total in this game. I'm going to go Winnipeg, lay the -116. That's a good price that's out there right now at Heritage Sports. Good price there. And also over 6. I think it's going to be a situation where Florida, like they did the other night against the Islanders, with Luongo not in net, this becomes a much greater over team. I mean, they're not going to be as good defensively. The goaltending's not going to be as good. PK's not going to be as good. They're not going to be able to keep the puck out of their net as easily. So I like the side and the total there. Give me the Jets and give me over 6 in that game against Florida. We've got both our ice guys into this game as well. Alex and Andrew talking about the Jets and the Panthers. Let's go to Andrew McInnes. Let's start with you. Winnipeg, Florida. What you got?
I was just saying that, you know, coming off that loss against Detroit, I mean, it's definitely one of those things where if you're going to see a team that's going to, you know, coming into that game, if you expected a lopsided victory, you expected that lopsided victory to really come from the Winnipeg Jets, not really the Detroit Red Wings. So I love this bounce back spot here. And I think it's kind of almost disrespectful, the Winnipeg Jets, that they're getting, you know, even that -117, -120 right now. I mean, you know, this is one reason why I do like the fact that we have this show early on, guys, in the day. You know, sometimes it would be nice to have it on maybe lunchtime or something like that, get more people viewing in and tuning in live. But reasons like this, I do strongly believe that Winnipeg will close at a lot higher of a number, and there's reasons for it. I mean, they deserve to have more respect. They have not done too well on the road against the Panthers, and this Panthers team doesn't really have much depth at all. I mean, besides their number one D pairing, Keith Yandel and Aaron Ekblad, I don't really see anything that stands out on this blue line, the Florida Panthers. And like I said, I've been saying this, I've really been talking about the Jets for our past couple Ice Guys shows, but their depth is just second to none. Maybe not defensive depth, but you look at all three lines that they have, at their top three lines, they can roll, and they can score, and their power play is outstanding. They're averaging 3.39 goals per game, guys. Florida's averaging 2.9. They're putting up 30 shots a game easily, and those are all quality shots. Those are all good shots. But a couple of good stats here about Winnipeg. I kind of do like the over as well in this game. I'm leaning Winnipeg money line, but the total has gone over in 6 of Winnipeg's last 9 games when playing Florida. Total has gone under, though, in 17 of Winnipeg's last 25 games when playing on the road against Florida. So it's kind of a bigger kind of picture to look at. But again, this Winnipeg team, simply just because of the odds we were getting last night on the overnight, and right now, guys, this is just too strong of a team. And like Ian said, you look at a team like this off a loss, sometimes you got to just not think about it too much and just say, wow, like, can the Winnipeg Jets really go 2 in a row and against this kind of rather bummy team against the Florida Panthers? They love like let teams walk all over them. They love to get in those track meet style games. And I think the Winnipeg would gladly walk into one of those style games. Alex, do you agree on that?
Yeah, I absolutely agree on that. You know, and it was funny because I'm looking back over it. I'm like, wow, I'm like, this price is awfully short, especially for the fact that you have a Florida team that, you know, lost Luongo in the middle of that game. So Reimer coming in, they've already had goalie issues up and down all year, and the defense has been absolutely atrocious. So you got a Winnipeg team, not only 6-0 off of a loss, but they've won 5 of their last 7 as a favorite. This is the time of year now where something I had to learn the hard way is that, you know, you learn every day when you're betting sport. Favorites are the, you know, the thing to go with now as far as short favorites, at least. You know, I'm a dog player, but I've been getting in with some chalky prices, and they've been cashing in. It's all about who wins at the end of the day. And if I can find a shorter favorite than something larger, I'm definitely going to ride with that. But like I said, this is a game where even with Luongo was healthy, I would have had this price at about $1.40. See, now you got Reimer in there. Reimer's 3-5-1 his career against Winnipeg. No illusions there. I'm going with the Jets.
Yeah, I mean, Reimer's numbers, we see it. 3.67 goals against, .892 save percentage. That's not nearly good enough. It's got to be better than that. And certainly he's going to – and now you got to be thrown into the fire here. Now, he came in for Luongo in the middle of that Islander game the other night. This is going to be your first start now since Luongo got injured. And you've got to do it against one of the most potent power plays and one of the most potent offensive teams right now going in this Winnipeg Jets team. And, yeah, they got held to one goal by Detroit, but that was just one of those, you know, no one stopping on, no one was beating Detroit the other night. I mean, that's just the way they played. They were just, they were diving to block shots left and right, something you rarely ever saw from them and a lot of teams in the regular season. They absolutely desperately wanted and needed that game. I don't really fault Winnipeg too much for losing that one against Detroit. I think they got a good chance to bounce back here.
Hey guys, thanks for tuning in to our channel. Now we've put a lot of work into producing all these free videos, so please help us out and keep all our content free for you forever by simply liking, sharing, commenting, and subscribing. Now not to mention, a visit to our industry-leading website will warm the hearts of all our SBR employees, especially myself. Now the links are over there to the left, so do check those out. Thanks for watching.